I'm doing it. Okay. Well, here we are. Back a couple weeks, or it's been a couple weeks. So we're back again. Skaz, introduce us.
We are the handsome hooligans. We have a fancy little marquee now. Yeah. We're all very proud of it.
Yeah, my wife bought one. We did it for something else, and then I was like, oh, I want to put the handsome hooligans. So we're finally up in golden lights.
Golden lights?
Well,
golden
but the
lights,
light,
you say.
Golden lights. Our name, or displaying our names. Okay.
Hey, save it for the louder bombs. They get the idea. Stop,
okay,
stop.
Okay. Though, man, we need to rest control. Wait, I think it's a good idea for me to control it.
No.
The next thing you know, it's going to be ministry. That's where he's going straight to.
Ministry?
Anyway, no, I'm just joking.
Here, give me the
answer. Yeah, exactly. No, but okay. So, this time we're going to talk about the Smiths. Oh my, what is that vinyl? Vinyl, baby. Oh, yeah. So, the Smiths, Hatful of Hollow, which, in my opinion, is one of their worst albums. This is my favorite album.
This is one of the best albums ever in the history of music.
Yeah. Yeah, and it's, if I was stranded on a desert island,
I would not want this album.
Yeah.
I would want a boat.
Like,
or a satellite.
I would not ask for a radio. I wouldn't ask for a boat. I just ask for this album.
Yeah.
And not even a Walkman or anything.
I don't know. Maybe you could like make a boat out of it.
Yeah. I float away on it. Make a raft out of it. Well, it is double album.
Yeah, with my weight, we would just sink.
Yeah.
We're
going
to do this.
Yeah, okay, that wouldn't work. But, so, I listened to Morrissey's autobiography again. I got mad at him for a while, but then I was like, okay, I understand it. But, sometimes he can't give a compliment, or he can, but it's like, and then there's kind of a little.
Like a backhanded.
Yeah, like, oh, well, Johnny, you know, whatever. I can't.
That dress is horrible, but you wear it so well. Something like that.
Yeah.
Something like that, yeah. Yeah, it's like, oh, well, he's good. Anyway, yeah. But so dream, like he said, his head's always in the clouds, or, you know, it's, anyway, it's just.
But you know who he is.
Well, I know, but I think, why was I even bringing that up?
Hatful of Hollow.
Hatful of Hollow, oh, because he talks about Hatful of Hollow, he's the one, well, at least according to him, he's the one that presented it to Jeff Travis, and he's like, because he was so disappointed, Morrissey was so disappointed in the first album, he wanted to put this one out, and, you know, he liked the versions better, too. It was better recorded, anyway.
Yeah. What do you think, Cass?
I really, really like this album. This is the album that got me into the Smiths.
Mm-hmm.
But, I don't know, I remember reading that, and I was like, alright, that's probably true. But also, I read another Smith's biography, someone was like, it was just like put in a random order, it doesn't make any sense. And I was like, I could not agree any less with you. Like.
Well, I don't know, he didn't say anything about like the order, I mean, but it seems to flow really good.
Yeah,
so,
right?
So, whether they threw it together or not, it flows really well. We got, suddenly. Okay, so this is stuff, there's a lot of repeats from the first album, but most of the stuff for me are the recordings and versions are better than the first album, except for.
So we're going to split this up.
One that we'll talk about.
Multiple casts.
Yeah, so this one's just kind of the introduction one.
Yeah.
I guess, man, we're already wasting, how far are we into it? Where's Grape Ape at right now?
Grape Ape is about four to 5 miles away.
Okay, this is stupid. Okay.
All right, so anyway, let's first talk about the name of the album.
Oh, yeah. Actually,
Hatful of Hollow.
I don't even know what the heck that's all about.
To me, that is just an excellent name because you look inside of a hat,
It's full of hollow.
It's full of hollow.
It's empty.
It's empty, yeah.
So is that what it... Because I've never heard any theories on it.
I don't know why they named it that way. I just think it's kind of clever that they
named
it hat full of hollow because that's what's in a hat. Nothing. It's hollow.
Okay.
I don't know. I think Morrissey was just like, oh, this sounds so good. Johnny, what do you think? And Johnny was like, yeah, sure. Whatever.
Sure. He didn't even, like, make a...
And then Mike Jay said, hey, wait, I need my 25%.
That's the thing that...
It was originally just Hatful Hollow, and then Mike Joyce was like, well, what if we put an of in the middle?
Yeah. That he's brilliant. Mike Joyce, he added that of. Hatful Hollow.
Where would the world be without words like of?
Oh, you know, and one of the things... We're going to have a new subheading to our name. This Charming Smith's Cast, were the Handsome Hooligans, and the Friends of Mike Joyce.
That's our animated series.
That branch that's for peace?
Olive Branch,
yeah.
That'll be our animated series.
The Friends of Mike Joyce. we have these superpowers. So we don't know exactly where he got it, but it's a clever name.
Yeah, it's a good one.
Yeah.
Memorable.
So, okay, well, let's get into the album.
Okay.
The song.
So here's one thing that I read, and I can't remember where I read this, but I read this something about, somebody gave a critique about Morrissey, and this kind of ties into the name and also the songs and everything. So they said, Morrissey does a really great job of coming up with song titles and album titles, and then just forgets to write the rest of the song.
I mean, I know sometimes it's not like it's not a full story or whatever. You know, sometimes he'll like jump to one thing to the other. What did you say it was? Is that non sequiturs?
Yeah.
What exactly? What's the definition of a non sequitur?
Basically, you're talking about one thing, and then something just pops up.
Yeah.
And then you just go.
Okay,
to
so
talk.
Yeah, that's.
So,
I mean, that's actually, if you, all of his songs, all of a sudden he's like, talking about one thing and all of a sudden he's talking about, but they work, man.
Yeah.
I'm not saying it's bad, it's just that there was that one critique and I thought, you know, I wonder if he was talking about Morrissey more as a solo artist and not as much as the Smiths.
Or a novelist. Oh, did we even show that we have, I got it with me. Morrissey the novelist. Oh my gosh.
What is that?
Get that out of here.
List of the lost.
Let's see.
No,
let's see.
Okay, it's really, really bad. Anyway, we're going to do a giveaway. If anybody comments.
Certain that he was alone in the house, Harry wearily lumbered down the stairs wearing only his white briefs as he squinted from the dazzle of an overdone 9 a.m. sun that cut through the house wherever it could.
This is so bad. It's all like that. Anyway, so Stephen the novelist. So that's awful. It's just awful and all full of non-sequiturs.
Yeah. So, anyway. Back to Hatful. Have you guys... I want to talk a little bit before we get into the actual songs, but... I think Morrissey was, like, really big into alliteration at this time. Because, like, you've got Hatful of Hollow as the title, and then for, like, the first half, a ton of the songs just start with the same letter for, like, two songs. So, like,
William,
What Difference? These Things Take Time, This Charming Man.
How soon is three of them.
Yeah.
Three of them in a row. And then maybe he's trying to spell out something.
Yeah.
That is kind of weird. But, I don't know.
So,
yes, we don't know how they came up with the order. Okay, well, let's just jump in. Now, are you playing? Turn it up a little bit.
Okay, so that's William.
Yeah, and I'm sorry, I got my notes. Anyway, so this start is a good, strong start, kind of a...
Yeah.
The guitar's kind of interesting, like it's almost like he's like...
Yeah.
Like kind of fumbling almost. I mean, not that he's playing it wrong, but the way it sounds is kind of like, it's hard to play.
Yeah, no. And he like all does it on acoustic guitar as well.
You know, I hate acoustic guitars.
What? That's not acoustic? No, he overdubs, I think. He overdubs. Anyway, you know, when I was listening to Johnny Mars, though, and it was just like, whenever he takes these into the studio, all of a sudden he just like does all this crazy stuff with overdubbing different guitars going backwards and forwards.
No, he does, but like he wrote William on an acoustic guitar, and he just kind of kept it that way, I think. But he said that he really likes the acoustic guitar because people just kind of view it as like a gentle instrument, but sometimes it's really good for being like very brash, and I think this is a case where it really works.
Yeah, see,
I didn't realize that was an acoustic guitar.
I'm pretty sure it is. I could be wrong. I could be wrong.
Well, no, I'm not.
Okay, but I like acoustic guitars.
Oh, yeah?
To listen to, but not to play. They hurt my fingers because you can't hold down the strings harder. You know.
Well, yeah, it's a lot.
Especially on crappy like $10 guitars.
Oh, like a nice Johnson.
Yeah,
Louis Johnson.
Yeah.
Sitting right over those here.
Those suck.
but yes,
William is good. What else?
I like the story. Oh yeah.
Yeah.
So he's like.
So what's the story about?
William.
No,
let me, you know what, it's funny, whenever you put me on the spot, I'm like, oh, no.
I think I remember.
Oh, go ahead.
It's about his friend, who didn't go by William, but had, like, a name very similar to William, who was gay and kind of being forced to be in this relationship with this woman who he didn't really love, but she said, no one wants to marry me, and you're gay, so we should just get married to succumb to social pressure. And then in return, that guy actually wrote a song for Morrissey, and it was like, Stephen, you were really something.
Yeah, I remember
what?
That. I remember reading about something like that. Yes, it's William, it was really nothing, and then Stephen.
You were really something.
Yeah, you were really something. Something like that. Yeah,
really?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Huh.
I do remember
reading. Well, so I like the line, you know, how can you stay with a fat girl?
They say,
"If would you like to marry me? And if you'd like, you can buy the ring."
Yeah.
But
if you'd like, you can buy the ring.
If you're going, yeah. So this fat chick, dude, this is no fat chick zone right here.
Hey, I always default to Spinal Tap for that.
Spinal, fat bottom, or
big bottom.
Big bottom. Big bottoms. Big bottoms.
I wish
you
I had
want
that,
bum cakes. Anyway, so this one's really good, but I didn't even realize there was anything about I just like the picture he paints of the rain coming down on this humdrum, you know.
Yeah.
He tells a little story with, and I mean, and not a lot of words, but he really paints a good picture. I mean, it's only like two paragraphs, you know,
yeah.
Or not even actual paragraphs, so just a couple sentences. Anyway, I mean, I'm trying to think of anything else to say about this song.
Top of the Pops, he borrows Elvis Costello's guitar and plays, and it's really funny because on the neck it just says Elvis Costello, like all the way up, instead of having like circles, yeah, or bars or whatever.
Oh, it says his name.
Yeah, so I don't know. Oh, and of course, legendary Top of the Pops performance. Morrissey opens up his shirt and it says "Marry Me" on his chest, and he's just singing along, and everybody is like, "Holy crap!"
For this song?
Yeah, for this song.
I haven't seen that one.
Yeah, it's great.
I got his hair on my chest.
Yeah, watch all of the Top of the Pops Smith stuff.
That's because I'm not a good parent. My kid stays in his room all day watching.
Why is he
dying?
Oh, what's this? Top
hey,
of the Pops.
Hey.
Shoot.
One time
that's
I was
what
watching
all kids
it in the
do now.
One time I was watching it in the living room with my headphones in, and you came in and you guessed like every single one of their videos. You were like, "Oh, this is Shoplifters. Oh, this is Heaven Knows."
That's right, man. That's why he's on the Hands of Holians.
Yeah,
well, I'm only here because you guys needed
power.
The space.
Because
it was actually Mark and Kaz that were going to do this, and they said, "Oh, by the way,
what?
You know, since we need somewhere to shoot, you can Maybe you could be a part of that.
We were going to get Mike Joyce in on it, but he wanted 25%.
We said, you'd be the third member. You'd get like 33, and he was like, I'm adamant.
Yeah. Hey, Wolverine is adamantium. I'm adamant. Team.
Moving on.
Anyway.
Moving on. What difference does
okay.
it make?
Okay, so, yeah.
What difference does it make?
Oh, yeah. So good. So this is the one where we were talking in the first, on the first album, their hippopotamously named album. I'm just joking. I've been saving that. Their hippopotamously named album. Eponymously. Anyway, where I was like, this version is so bad. Here, wait. Oh, Steve, that's what I was going to.
No.
Oh,
you
no.
brought it?
Oh. What the heck is this?
I'm on it.
Do you know this song?
Yeah, this is
Flight of the Conchords.
Oh, I haven't.
Listen.
Okay. Okay.
Listen,
the
hip-hop. The They call me the hip-hop.
Okay, okay.
And the lyrics are bottomless, and then he just stopped. He's like,
I can't think of anything to say. All right, so here,
okay.
play the beginning of that again.
Okay.
Not the hippopotamus song.
You want the hippopotamus song?
I want a hippopotamus for Christmas.
Oh.
I want a hippopotamus for Christmas. Okay. So play the beginning. Now pause and now listen to this. Crap. Same. Now play that. Like it's just like so much more punched up.
Yeah.
I love it. Oh yeah. Okay.
The drums are just so awesome.
Yeah, that's one thing. Like the complaint about the first album, one of the big ones was not enough cowbell, but second one the drums were not loud enough either.
Yeah, the drums sounded thin.
Yeah, and they do. And then you hear this one and it's like, you know, really aggressive drumming. And actually I was listening to it on the way over and I was like, he really, you know, you're really aggressive drumming, even on some of the slower stuff.
Probably because he was told he wasn't going to get 25%.
Actually,
a lot of the drums.
Like, what, 10%? Anyway, yeah, so, like this version, actually this is one of my favorite Smith songs, and I'm just going to, this version of it.
You're going to put it out there, huh?
I'm going to put it out there.
Ooh,
sorry.
You're making a statement.
I know that Morrissey's not crazy about this song, and that's his problem.
That's probably a good thing to have this be your favorite song then.
Why?
Because Morrissey doesn't like it, so you know that it's the right song.
Actually,
what? He wrote it!
You want to know a fun fact about this song?
Yeah, I do.
Morrissey actually said that he thinks Simon Le Bon from Duran Duran could write it better. He thinks that if Simon Le Bon wrote it instead of him, it would have been a lot better. Which is just a very weird thing, being like, Morrissey...
Duran Duran's not that bad, I'm sorry.
No, it's just like, it's very strange to hear Morrissey be like, yeah, Duran Duran probably would have done it better.
But
he must have been saying that as in, like, you know, like a derogatory... Oh, you know, to himself, like, saying, like, it's so bad that even Simon Le Bon could have written a better song.
Maybe.
Kind of, like, it's a knock on Simon Le Bon and a knock on himself.
I think
what he's saying, right?
Actually, I think he really liked Duran Duran.
Whatever.
He didn't like a lot of
electronic
songs.
I
liked A-ha.
That's true.
He did like A-ha.
A-ha.
Okay, no.
Anyway. Oh no, I actually I have the note for this is just the drum roll change. So go to 120.
120.
On your thing. Mm-hmm. So he's like doing the rolling drums. Yeah,
114.
Listen. Okay, fine. So he's like Okay, it's coming up. No. Okay. There it is. He changed it up. Pause.
Alright.
I'm just saying, he's like, there's this part where he just keeps on doing the brrrr.
See, this is brrr, where the friends of Mike Joyce brrr, brrr, comes in.
And then instead of the roll, he does this little.
That's because he broke one of the drums.
Drumstick. Whatever. I don't even do that.
It's like, I can't play that drum anymore. Okay, change it.
Oh, okay, I thought you were going into the beef jerky stick thing.
Oh.
Never mind. Anyway.
No, that's
totally separate. But, okay. So anyway, so this song, I mean, because Morrissey's vocals, the drums, the bass, you know, and the bass is turned up on this, it's just like, The guitar, yeah, it doesn't have that cheesy effect on it. It's just like kind of another aggressive, you know, guitar. It's just really, everything's perfect in this song for me.
Okay.
So what difference does it make?
That's right.
So, shoot, man, we're just going through these.
You're right. What difference does it make? But you know what else? These things take time.
Well, they do take time.
So...
What? No, or are we gonna... No.
Yeah.
What?
I think Grape Ape is here.
Grape. That sounds so stupid. Forget it, man. Okay, Grape Ape was supposed to be our cutoff sign. We're going
so
too long.
So anytime I say Grape Ape, it means we're cutting this cast off.
I know, but we're only like...
You know how many people have been commenting on these videos saying, you guys talk way too dang long?
Nobody, actually.
Exactly, nobody. Nobody's watching
it. No, I know who you're talking about, and it's always been Grape Ape. That's why he's here. He's like,
when I scroll around the YouTube netherworld, I'm always looking for like alien videos or Hollow Earth videos that are like 8 minutes or less.
Well, I know, but we're 25 minutes into this.
Exactly.
Yeah, that's because we're getting to the bottom of this Hollow Earth.
That's
thing.
Right.
Hey, listen, we are gonna do. These things take time.
These things take time. Yeah. Okay. Remember how the one starts off with the surf drums and stuff?
Yeah.
And then all of a sudden, listen to this version. It's yours.
Why could you fall asleep during what difference does it make? Hold on, here it comes.
Okay, we better pause. I mean, Mike Joyce is definitely gonna come for a podcast money. For a podcast money.
So anyway.
So it's
like that.
But it just like serious, like it just jumps into it.
You're right, it jumps into it, but I want to play that one lyric because that dates this song so bad.
What?
Wait.
Disused farewell line? Or?
No, we can go to a place where we are not known. You know how hard that is in today's world?
Oh, good.
What do you mean? Like are you saying for
like,
Morrissey?
No. Not just for him, but for anybody. You have social media out there with all these weird things like Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, Tumblr. You have Foursquare check-ins, you have Facebook check-ins, you have live videos all over the dang place, which is actually kind of funny, because you know what? And here's why I bring this up. There's this really funny video online, and I was looking at it this morning, and I just laughed. So Shia LeBeouf, okay, I'm not getting political here.
Oh, is this that do it thing?
Yeah, he will not divide us. This is his protest. Shia LeBeouf was protesting Trump, and he set up like this artsy thing where he put a camera up on the wall, right? And everybody was able to come in and say, he will not divide us, he will not divide us, and just say it as many times as he wants. But a whole bunch of trolls showed up, and overtook the whole thing. So he had to close it down in New York. He opened it up in Albuquerque, and the same thing happened. He got trolled there, and so he said, screw it, I'm just going to put up a flag on a pole that says he will not divide us. In a field, and all the camera was supposed to be on 24/7 for the whole entire presidency of Donald Trump. all it was a flag that said, he will not divide us, on a pole that showed the sky. That's the only thing in the frame. People online went out, looked at the stars, looked at the flight patterns.
What?
Triangulated where this flagpole was, went out there.
Wait, Steve, you're really going into this.
That's what I'm saying. So he's
actually Shia LeBeouf.
So this is funny because they went out, they replaced the flag, right? This is supposed to be 100% online all the time. And it's supposed to be a flag that says, he will not divide us, anti-Trump type of thing. These trolls went out there, found the flagpole, replaced the flag with a Donald Trump Make America Great Again hat. And the feed went offline. And the reason he did that is because he kept getting trolled everywhere else he went. So you can't go to a place anymore that you are not known because...
Well,
anywhere.
I know, but yeah, you can, Steve, if you're not... Like, updating your Facebook and take your... You know, you can still be alone.
Use your ATM card?
Yeah, just use cash.
Even, are you going to travel with that much cash?
I know, but... Anyway, I understand
saying,
what you're saying,
I'm just
but...
That line dates the song. And a lot of... And it's not a problem. It's not a problem that it dates the song.
Well, yeah,
But the,
well, it's just so. I mean, if they like in where Joan of Arc or her Walkman started to melt, you know, that dates the song.
Exactly.
Anyway, it's just an old term for.
Exactly. Well, when I first got married to Elise, I bought some vinyl and I took it over to her house, and her little brother was there, and I said, I really love the sleeve notes. And he had no idea what I was talking about. And it wasn't like he was 3 years old. He was a senior in high school. And he had no idea what sleeve notes were at all.
Whoa,
I said,
yeah, I mean, my
I lady. Said, you know, like the cover notes that you would get on a CD? And he's like, no, I don't. I'm like, I can't be that old.
You are.
I mean,
I guess kids these days, is that what these things take time?
These things take time, no, Sonny. That's what I'm saying is some
Steve.
Of the lyrics are so hard
to
relate to some of the kids.
Let's jump to Kaz.
In today's generation. Kaz is going to be a little bit different because we've had
I'm saying, what do you think about this song?
I really like this song. I really like it a lot. But also, I really think that this was written like kind of early on in their career. Because I feel like it's Morrissey trying to say, like, this is a great thing we've got going on, but you're probably going to leave me, Johnny. Like,
you know, these things take time. It's not going to happen overnight.
Yeah.
Really?
The line, mine eyes have seen the glory of the sacred wonderkind. You know what a wonderkind is, right? It's someone...
Is it Wonder Bra?
It's someone...
A wonderkind.
Yeah, Wunderkind is someone who is incredibly talented at an incredibly young age.
Yeah.
Johnny, who is like 18, 19 years old and a master at guitar, he'd be a Wunderkind.
Wunderkind.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. And just like.
And then he took Morrissey
and
behind a disused railway line.
Yeah.
A what?
A disused railway line. Did you think he said something else? That happens
to
me a lot. There's lots of...
And then vivid and in your prime, you will
leave
me behind.
Listen,
I think it's just...
This song has direct correlations to a song on...
I swear.
This has a direct correlation to a song on Strange Ways.
Okay.
I'm spellbound, but a woman divides.
So she's a mathematician, right?
No. Not a mathematician.
Are you saying I won't?
She's really good at math.
No. It's not that.
Oh, I know.
That's what I said.
Or turn down a little bit. What did he eat? Not that much. So, okay, what's the correlation?
It's about Johnny Marr.
Yeah.
And his wife at the time. I'm not going to share you with your wife.
No.
This was before they got married.
The girls that are coming after him.
Oh, yeah. Woman divides? I thought it was a woman.
Yeah. No.
I thought it was some...
A woman divine?
No, I knew it was a woman divides. I thought it was kind of a sexual thing. I don't know.
Oh, yeah. No.
It's like,
well,
I don't know. Somebody had said something about that. Anyway, I don't even want to...
It
doesn't make sense. But I'm saying, Morrissey never felt like that Angie was ever anything other than helpful, and he even states that. And if he had something against her, he would have said it in his autobiography.
He had nothing bad
to say about her.
But in Johnny Marr's autobiography, he talks about how he's called up one night by, what's her face?
Angie?
No. Somebody that he worked with before, and she said, hey, come over and play guitar with us.
Oh.
Who's us? And he goes over there, and he's, and Keith Richards is there.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
And
okay.
So it's like, Johnny is out there, you know, hey, we're starting to get some fame, and I'm actually rubbing elbows with some of my heroes and icons. And Morrissey's like, whoa, wait, you know, we can't keep going off in all these directions. We have to be focused on the Smiths.
Oh, I won't share you. I thought you were still talking about
it. Oh, no, yeah.
Even this.
But that was written, like, very early on.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. I'm spellbound, but a woman divides and the hills are alive with celibate cries.
Yeah. Remember, Morrissey had already been... he was already trying his stab at fame before, and he was a huge New York Dolls fan. He was a huge fan of other groups. He saw what happened when they started getting some small fame to them, that they would, you know, start chasing tail.
See, I always looked at the song. It was just kind of like,
that's
hey,
what I saw.
He likes this girl. You know, but he, again, kind of, you know, she wants him, you know, the hills are alive with celibate cries, so he's still, you know, kind of like, what was that song that we were talking about? No, on the first album, I'm Not the Man You Think I Am. You know, it's like, well... Nature's calling out, saying, you know, I should be celibate. I don't know, man.
Okay, and I'm just giving you what I feel about the song. That's what I see, is that he's trying to give the band a warning. Quit trying to rub elbows with everybody. Quit trying to go get that girl. Let's be, you know, not necessarily celibate, but let's be rational about what we're doing going forward, and not just, oh, look at all these groupies that want to make out with us right now.
Hmm.
It's...
Okay, I didn't... You know, it...
It's like, our time is going to come. We just gotta hang in there.
Okay.
So, according to Songs That Saved Your Life, The Art of the Smiths, this song was written in the winter of 1982, like, just after the Smiths formed. So, just...
All this stuff was early. I mean, this is all really early in there.
And if we look, and I'm not saying Morrissey is this smart, okay? But if we...
Yeah, that's the thing. You're really... sometimes I think maybe we overread into him because...
And it could be.
Maybe it's just a bunch of non sequiturs. It's like, hey, this works. You know?
See, the thing is if you look at a group the same way as a business, the smart people that go into business... They have a plan. They have a business plan, and they stick to the plan, and they don't start spreading out to everything just because something comes up. And it's the same with a group.
You know, I mean, I could see, okay, the woman divides, like, you know, all of a sudden somebody starts dating somebody, and all of a sudden next thing you know, they're not even talking to you anymore.
Who was huge back in the early
Beatles?
80s?
Well, no, but I'm saying Yoko Ono.
Exactly, Yoko Ono and John Lennon.
Oh, okay, you were talking about that.
Yeah.
Okay, good.
Yeah, exactly, and look what Yoko did to the Beatles, which I don't like personally. I don't like the Beatles at all, but Yoko Ono, no, I don't.
You don't like the early stuff? Rubber Soul.
I think Dave Clark Five was a lot better than the Beatles.
Dave Clark Five. Wasn't the Dick Clark Five?
No, not Dick Clark. Dave Clark Five. So anyway,
I'm more of a Herman Hermits.
I like them too.
Me too.
But the thing is that that's all in the news, and he's like, before we go out and start, you know, living like fame, like Blur did when they got famous. It was like them and Oasis trying to get the award for the most raunchous rock star lifestyle.
Blur did that?
Yeah. Them and Oasis.
I remember Oasis, you know, what's his name, always.
Yeah, they were very notorious for going into hotels and just trashing rooms left and right.
Hey, so is Craig Gatton.
Yeah.
Who's one of the...
So anyway,
the fifth Smith, like the fifth Beatle.
That's what I take away from the song. Now, everybody else can probably take something else.
Kaz?
It's,
that's interesting, because I never...
I bet.
You know what? I think I just don't give a lot of thought to these lyrics. I mean, you know, I'm just so used to hearing them and hearing them and hearing them.
Well, the reason being is because
Kaz.
Mark had a social life. I didn't, so I stayed
home. No,
I'm
not saying that. But
Mark was out
you know, I've listened to him so much, and they just kind of become such a part of your life. And you're not analyzing them because you got this good music going and everything, and the vocals are good and stuff. So you're more just listening to them, but not ingesting them, you know.
Huh.
Or you're making me.
Again,
you're listening to them, but it's like an instrument.
You had a social life, I guess.
Sorry. Anyways, you were asking me about my opinion of this song.
Yeah.
Yes.
I bet you already know my opinion of this song. It's really gay. It's a really gay song.
What?
Come on. You know Morrissey was like, I'm so in love with this guy. I don't know.
Okay.
No,
with Johnny Marr.
No, but
you gotta
remember they were like a gay band at first. They were going to have themselves as a gay
they
band.
They seriously were. They had that guy wearing heels, go-go dancing by
their
him.
Their first song
was
I Want a Boyfriend.
I Want a Boyfriend, a new boy for my birthday, and Handsome Devil. What? Oh wait,
it's right here.
No,
Handsome Devil's in here. We won't cover.
Okay,
that.
we're gonna wrap this one up. I think we wasted a lot of time this one, and we're gonna wrap this one up. We'll fade out with These Things Take Time, and
you
want to make
These Things Take Time?
Well, yeah, we'll just fade out with it, and we'll come back. All right, there we go.
This is who are we?
With
the
handsome holding hands on the marquee.
Man rocks.
Oh man, okay, that one was a little.